Hey, it's Dr. Amanda with Straight Smile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today I'm going to be making a video and talking about third molars or wisdom teeth, or eights, or whatever you want to call them. This video today is going to be more focused towards dentists, orthodontists, and medical dental professionals, less towards the patients about third molars. Although if you are a consumer, you're welcome to listen to this video. I'll be using technical language. I do have some more simple videos on third molars that if you wanna look up within my channel, third molars or wisdom teeth, there's some good videos that are more patient facing to get a little bit slower. So today we're gonna be talking about specifically the intricacies of third molars or wisdom teeth with orthodontics, specifically Invisalign or clear aligners, clear correct. Should you get them out? Should you not get them out? Can you leave them in? Do you need to cover them? Do you cover them half, two thirds, fully? How does that work? And really, this is a complicated question because if you pull 100 orthodontists, you're gonna get 100 different answers. So I'm gonna tell you my answer, which I think is a relatively conservative answer, and it's kept me out of hot water for 20 years. So I learned the hard way because I was initially in some hot water with third molars. So I kind of changed my opinion. So in residency, most of the research that we read said, third molars don't matter, you're fine. No need to get them out unless they are partially erupted, have a risk of pericarditis, have decay, or a patient can't keep them clean, perio, stuff like that. And that's kind of the land that we live by. And in braces, you know, that's fine because you're not moving them anyways and they're just hanging out. So it's usually not a big deal. But fast forward, now we're in the wonderful world of aligners and more patients are getting aligners over braces and it changes things. So let's talk about, first of all, fully impacted molars, what to do. So a lot of this is gonna depend on the age of the patient, the symptoms of the patient, the type of movements you're gonna do. If they're under 25 and the molars are more than two thirds developed and or mesially angulated, but fully impacted, I'm most likely going to have them taken out before treatment. Why? Because even though a lot of research says they don't matter, a court of public opinion says they do matter. If and when your patient had unknown, unpredicted movements or relapse later and they did shift, even if you had them wearing a retainer, you'd probably be paying for their new treatment if and when they complain to the dental board or the insurance. So for that reason, I recommend that they come out because it's going to cause trouble later if and when things happen. And sometimes it could be unpredictable and we don't know why. And again, court of public opinion says you're wrong, they're right. So hence is why I get them out. If patient is really, really, really anti, I'm gonna have them sign an extra piece of paper saying it was recommended that I get them out. I've chosen not to. I realized that Dr. So-and-so is not responsible for any relapse now or in the future. Any additional fees, any new retainers needed, or if there's any delay in my treatment and treatment is extended due to any issues with the third molars, there'll be additional fees of X per month and or additional lab fees. And usually that covers you. You might want to have an attorney help who knows ortho and knows dentistry, help you draft that. If you need some referrals to attorneys, I've worked with some that are really great with dentistry and they're not that expensive and they'll be glad to do that for you. And or your liability insurance company probably has stuff like that already on draft. No, I don't have that form. And I do try not to have that many legal forms floating around because each state and every country is different, every dental board is different, and you really should be writing your own. And anyways, I recommend you just get them out. So, okay, so that was the fully impacted version. In a younger patient, in an older patient, maybe same thing, probably less of an issue. Especially, you can always send them to OS and OS might clear them to go ahead and start or might say it's not a good idea, then at least you get that in writing. Okay, let's talk about partially erupted ones. So partially erupted ones, I think are a ticking time bomb. Those need to come out. I don't treat patients with them partially erupted. That's a hard no on my word, on my end. I just won't do it. So no thanks. I tell them they can go elsewhere, get them out. Or we can wait till they fully erupt and then we can cross that bridge. Can't promise you can keep them in. I'll have to reevaluate at that time. So that's easy. Then we've got the fully erupted ones. For me, for fully erupted ones, they have to be fully covered by the tray, which likely means we're gonna have to take a scan and not an impression. So if you don't already have a scanner, that sucks, time to get one. So if you're gonna be doing that, or at least two thirds covered. And that's a tricky thing. And that's, you know, not everyone's doing that. Why? Because they're going to super erupt over time. And they also need to be fully covered in the retention as well. If you're doing Asics retainers, if you're doing Holly or bonded, that's not a big deal. So, yeah, I mean, and then also just to add one more thing, if you are closing spaces, consolidating spaces, not just from front to back, but, you know, all around the house, that means smushing up all the spaces from front to back, back to front. That means moving all the molars. You have to have them fully covered, and it needs to wrap around the back side of them, or it's not going to work unless you have a ton of attachments. If you are doing distalization, you have to have them fully covered. If you're using elastics, they need to be fully covered. You get the idea. So it really also depends on the movements that you're doing. If you're just doing anterior movements only, you can probably get away with 2/3 of coverage. So keep that in mind as you're doing your impressions in your scan, and make sure you're communicating that to not only the patient, but also to your team to make sure they're getting quality scans, quality photos, etc. Hopefully this was helpful. Thanks so much.